Good morning, Standard 4th, Subject, EBS Part 2, Lesson Number 18, Management of the Welfare State of Swaraj. Lesson Number 18, Management of the Welfare State of Swaraj. Shivaji Maharaj struggled long against many unjust power. They were the Adilshahi and the Mughal powers, the Portuguese and the Siddhis of Janjiram. That is how an independent Hindvi Swaraj was created. For smooth working, Shivaji Maharaj divided the administration into 8 departments. He appointed a minister in charge of each. This was his famous council of 8 ministers. The Swaraj of Shivaji Maharaj was a state run for the welfare of the people in the true sense of term. It was run with the assistance of the 8 ministers. Shivaji Maharaj himself made the appointments of these 8 ministers and other important officers on the basis of their eligibility and merit. He supervised all their work. People lived happily in Swaraj created by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Therefore, the qualities of confidence, self-respect and patriotism strongly embraced among the people of Maharashtra. Shivaji Maharaj divided the administration into 8 departments and Shivaji Maharaj also appointed a minister in charge of each. This was his famous council of 8 ministers. The council of 8 ministers. First, Moru Trimbak Pingle, Pradhan, administration. Second, Ramchandra Nilkantha Mujumdar, Amatya, revenue and accounts of the state. Third, Hambirao Mohite, Senapati defense. Fourth, Moreshwar Panditrao, Panditrao religious matter. Fifth, Niraji Raoji, Nyayadish justice. Sixth, Annaji Datto, Sachiv government orders. Seventh, Dattaji Trimbak Vaknis, Mantri correspondence. Eighth, Ramchandra Trimbak Dabir, Sumant, foreign relation. People happily live in Swaraj created by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Protection of environment. Natural environment includes the land and nature as also factors like air, rain, rivers and streams, sea, forests, the birds and the animals, light received from the sun, etc. It is beneficial for man to make use of this environment only to meet his necessities. Shivaji Maharaj took precautions to avoid the destruction of these environmental factors. Shivaji Maharaj saw to it that the forest in his kingdom would not be destroyed by the people from the royal edicts. We can see that he had issued many orders like the following. For the navy, it is necessary to build boats and ships of a various size and their beams, mats, etc. for which boats it is required to obtain this wood only teak trees should be cut. If more teak wood is required, it should be purchased from foreign territories. But on no account should mango, jackfruit or other trees be cut. They don't grow in a year or two. People look after them like their own children. In order to grow them. Cutting them is to inflict sorrow on the people. It should not be done even when a tree is greatly worn out. It should be cut only after paying the owner and getting his consent. Natural environment included the land in nature, as also factors like air, rain, rivers and stream seeds, forest, the birds and animals, light received from the sun, etc. It is beneficial for man to make use this environment only to meet his necessities. Shivaji Maharaj took precautions to avoid the destruction of these environmental factors. Shivaji Maharaj saw to it that the forest in his kingdom would not be cut by the people. He had issued many orders like following. For the navy, it is necessary to build boats and ships of various size and their beams, mats, etc. Only teak trees should be cut. If more teak wood is required, it should be purchased from foreign territories. But no account should mangoes, jackfruits or other trees be cut, because these trees don't grow in a year or two. People look after this tree like their own children in order to grow them. Cutting them, it is to inflict sorrow on the people. Water management. Shivaji Maharaj had various bunds built near the village in Swaraj to make drinking water available to the people. Canal were dug out to make water available for agriculture. Due to this, there was an increase in the produce. People in Swaraj never felt the severity of droughts during the regime of Swaraj. Shivaji Maharaj, the number of people living on forts was quite large. Shivaji Maharaj took care to make proper arrangements for water on the forts. Before building a fort, the place was inspected to see whether enough water was available there. In case it didn't have water tanks and receivers were built where before the onset of the rainy season and rainwater was stored in them. The stored water was used economically. Due to such water management, people on the forts and other subjects in Swaraj did not suffer from shortage of water even during drought periods. Near the village in Swaraj, Shivaji Maharaj had various bunds built for agriculture. Canals were dug out to make water available on the fort. Number of the people living. Shivaji Maharaj took care to make proper arrangement for water on the fort. The store water was used economically. Due to such water management, people on the forts and other subjects in Swaraj did not suffer from shortage of water. Shivaji Maharaj gave various facilities to drought affected peasants. He used to waive tax so the severity droughts was required for people in Swaraj. In the drought year, Shivaji Maharaj distributed the grain store in the state granaries free of cost to the people. He also undertook repair of various forts and construction of dam, burns and canal during drought year. In this way, peasants and artisans or volunteers could earn their daily living and did not feel the severity of drought. As peasants became wealthy, he could afford to buy things like footwear, clothes, etc. This provided work to the artisans, those who were homeless, till then developed the capacity to build their own houses. This in turn provided work to the mason, the carpenters, the blacksmith, the brickmakers. This is how, along with the peasants in Swaraj, artisans also became happy and wealthy. Shivaji Maharaj gave various facilities to drought-affected farmers. He used to waive tax. Shivaji Maharaj distributed the grain store in the state granaries free of cost to the people. He also undertook repair of various forts and construction of dams, burns and canals during drought year. As the farmer became wealthy, he could afford to buy things like footwear, clothes, etc. This provided work to the artisans, those who were homeless till then, developed the capacity to build their own houses.